Canadian real estate is on fire. House prices are growing like there's no tomorrow. How long is this sustainable for? Are we gonna see a market correction in 2021? Well, in this video, I'm gonna talk about all of that and much more, so we're gonna answer all of your questions. So stay tuned and let's get into it. The word bubble or market correction or crash has been tossed around in many conversations. With jaw-dropping bidding wars and record-breaking house prices, the Canadian real estate prices, especially in places like Ontario, Vancouver, and I would say all over Canada, has grown at a pace that many would say it's unsustainable for the long term. However, this is what we've seen for the past 2020 and what is going on currently as well. In one of my last videos, I actually talked about if the Canadian real estate market was in a bubble. However, for this video, let's quickly define what a bubble is and then let's get into the factors that are gonna affect if the Canadian market is gonna correct itself or not. A real estate bubble can be defined when real estate prices grow significantly due to exuberant demand, speculation, shortage of supply, well, everything that's going on currently in Canada. Just this past week, the BOC or the Bank of Canada acknowledged that growing household mortgage debt and imbalances in the real estate market are two big threats that are coming for the Canadian real estate market. That said, the Canadian dream of owning a house with a yard is becoming more and more unaffordable as real estate prices surge like there's no tomorrow and supply for those homes is becoming more and more scarce. The rate at which real estate prices are increasing is definitely not in par with the rate of wage increases. Fewer and fewer Canadian households are making more than $100,000, meaning that this directly affects their ability to get a mortgage, especially in big metropolitan areas like Toronto and surroundings and Vancouver and surroundings. Therefore, Canadians wishing to live in the big metropolitan cities are going to have to either rent a place or, by default, increase their commute times just to get into the city. Now, let's get into my personal opinion of increasing real estate prices and how long is this sustainable for. Real estate has been an asset that has been performing really well for the past year and even currently. In cities like Toronto and surrounding areas and Vancouver and surrounding areas, real estate prices have risen anywhere from like 20 to 30%. And in most Canadian cities throughout Canada, that is also the case with real estate prices rising anywhere from like 10 to even 20%. Even if we look at Winnipeg, where is where I'm currently at, real estate prices have gone up anywhere from like 15 to 20% with bidding wars on properties that are not even that attractive listed at $250,000 and maybe selling for $300,000, so $50,000 over ask, and other properties listed for $350,000 which were going for $420,000 to $440,000. In my entire experience of living here in Winnipeg for over 7 to 8 years, I've never seen people overpaying for such properties. $50,000, $70,000, even $80,000 for properties that are in Winnipeg. So what does that mean? That means that the demand for real estate is still there. People who are not able to afford in provinces such as Ontario and British Columbia are coming to places like Winnipeg and buying up properties, as I've personally seen a big influx of out-of-province investors, especially coming from Toronto and Vancouver. That was for Winnipeg. However, a similar story is applicable throughout cities in Canada as real estate prices have risen everywhere, not just in the big metropolitan cities like Toronto, like Vancouver. Now, the question is, how long is this sustainable for? How long can real estate prices keep going up and up without seeing any type of correction? Well, in my personal opinion, we're not gonna see any type of real estate crash in 2021, as now we're entering the summer market, demand is there, fewer supply, so still the same kind of economics and the same kind of principles are applying. However, going into the future, I do see a correction, but not a huge correction. What do I mean by that? Based on the new imposed stress test by the Canadian government, fewer and fewer Canadians now are going to be eligible to buy a house and qualify for a mortgage, therefore lowering the demand. Just to illustrate my point of how interest rate plays a major role in the Canadian market for real estate and the demand for real estate, if we currently assume an interest rate of 1.5% and that interest rate were to increase by 2%, so an increase of 2% meaning to 3.5%, your mortgage payment would go up by 30%. Then, if we assume a 4% increase increase from the 1.5% now to 5.5%, your mortgage payment would go up by 60%. And last but not least, if we assume a mortgage interest rate of 7.5% from the original 1.5%, your mortgage payment would basically double, meaning it would go up by 100%. So that said, again, I don't expect the Canadian real estate market to crash in 2021. However, I do expect after June 1st, 2021, for the real estate market demand to lower due to the stress test now being applied at 5.25%, I believe, and lesser people being able to qualify for a mortgage. So all in all, the two scenarios that I do see for real estate demand to slower and the market not to crash, because I don't believe the market would correct itself so badly, are the first one being a spike in interest rates and the second one being a tightening in housing policy. So for the first one, if interest rates go up, lesser people are going to be able to actually qualify for a mortgage and then afford that mortgage monthly payments, so consequently lowering the demand for real estate. And for the second one to happen, the government would need to intervene, tighten those housing policies, and therefore the demand for real estate would lower consequentially. All right, that was the end of today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy today's video. If you guys did, make sure to smash that like button down below and subscribe to my channel, as that really helps me to reach more and more people like yourself. And let me know your comments in the comment section down below. Let me know your thoughts. Do you agree? You don't agree? I really love to hear that, and I reply to all of your comments. And until next time, see you guys on the tripod.